Hello guys, I hope all of you are doing fine. My name is Manshu and today I'm going to answer this one question. Tell me something about yourself. And I think guys, this is one question that intimidates a lot of candidates. And in this short video, I'm going to take you through what are the most important things that you need to keep in mind while you answer this question. So before we get started, guys, something about myself. My name is Manshu. By qualification, I'm an MA and MPhil in English Literature. I've been teaching students, training students, mentoring students for the last 11 years, and I secured a 99.74 percentile on the CAT verbal section. Guys, you can always follow me on Himanshu underscore Unacademy. That is my Telegram link, and I will be sharing session links with you on the Telegram. Okay, so guys, coming to the question. So tell me something about yourself. So guys, I'm not going to give you a structured approach as to what are the things that you need to talk about, whether or not you should talk about your family or you should talk about your name. No. What I'm going to tell you are the five most important things that you need to keep in mind, and these five things should feature in whatever answer you give to this question. Tell me something about yourself. So first thing, decide the direction. Now, guys, there is this one very big misconception, and I've heard a lot of people talk about this. So they say that this is a trick question. Tell me something about yourself, and the interviewer is trying to trick you. No, this is not a trick question, guys. This is basically an opportunity to the interviewer for the interviewer to come up with new questions. Because you have to understand something, guys, in today's digital world, any candidate who enters the room of the interviewer is sharing those questions that have been asked on the internet, and the interviewer wants to ensure that he comes up with new question every time whenever there's a new candidate. So obviously it is impossible to come up with so many new questions. So what he does is that he asks this open-ended question, tell me something about yourself, and from the answer to that question itself, he takes out new questions, and obviously in this way he can ask unique questions to every candidate who comes for the interview. So what do you do? First of all, do introspection and decide what are the things that you would like to talk about. For example, would you like to talk about your academics? Would you like to talk about your marketing skills? Do you have a personality trait that makes you better than the others? Do you want to talk about your family background? Okay, so let's say you come from an army background and that makes you better because you have a very disciplined life. Okay, you have been living in a certain hostel and that makes you a very disciplined person. You are a person of integrity and you want to talk about that. You are someone who has done the best sales for a company and you want to talk about that. So guys, just do some introspection, just do some groundwork and think about those things where you really score above the others, and that can decide the direction of the interviewer. It may be as simple as, let's say, your knowledge of your own city. If you put emphasis on your city and what and how your city is unique, then you give the interviewer the opportunity to ask you more questions about your own city. So you decide the direction of the interview. What value do you add? So guys, you have to remember this, that if you are selected for a certain college, you need to get placed. Okay, and this is the responsibility of the college to get you placed. So the college itself is under pressure to take such students who are easier to place. So just think about this. What are the things, or what are the unique things about you as a person make you better to get placed? Okay, so it can be your skills of communication, it can be your skills of number crunching, it can be your skills of computers, it can also be your skills of sales, it can also be skills of marketing. There can be n number of things you can talk about, but whatever you are good at is what you bring to the table. And this batch that the college is trying to make, this batch should be unique, should be diverse, and every person has something or the other he can bring to the table and he can share with the other students. And you have to really think about that. What are those things that make you better? Okay, so what is the value you add? What is the USP, unique selling proposition? So guys, every person is good in some or the other thing. Every person has a unique personality aspect that makes him or her better. Okay, आपको सोचना पड़ेगा, what are those unique things that really make you better or different? And guys, believe me, you will get the answer. Okay, every person has something different. Every person has done something or the other that makes him better. And there are certain things in which you can always perform better than the others. Okay, so you have to just think about that, right? What are your achievements? So guys, this is one question that a lot of people are confused about, because some people say that, sir, I don't have any achievements. Okay, see, every person in the world has some or the other achievements. You may not realize it. Yes, I accept the fact that there can be some people who have more achievements than you do. But that is not the question. The question is, what are the achievements that you have? So guys, think about it like this. First of all, think about whatever achievements you have done during your time of graduation. Okay, then think about things where you might not have the certificate to prove, but then still those things could be considered an achievement. Okay, now achievement can be anything. You managed a certain seminar, that is an achievement. You were involved with the marketing drive of your own college, that can be an achievement. Even the fact that you helped your business, your father's business, achieve a certain goal of revenue is also an achievement. So a lot of people are confused and they are under a lot of stress because they don't really have the certificates to prove a certain type of achievement. Now guys, having a certificate as a credential to prove that you did something is always good. I accept it. But then in those situations where you don't have the certificate, even the fact that you did something and you can sell that idea that, sir, this is something that I did and this was really good. These were the sales numbers that I put in. This is how I got appreciation from my teachers. This was the value that I added to my father's business. This is the amount of sales that I did for a certain company. It can be anything, guys. And believe me, if you are really honest and if you give your answer with conviction, even the fact that you don't have the certificate, still the people will believe you and that will really work, because you don't have to unnecessarily stress about the fact that you don't have enough certificates. Okay. The last thing, how your personality suits the profile. So guys, this is something that is really important. I'm going to tell you something. Every person has a unique personality, and for every profession, you require certain personality traits. The very fact that you're going to get into management and eventually you would choose some or the other profile, if it's sales or marketing or HR or any other profile or operations, okay, you need a certain personality trait combination. And I think that most of us are smart enough, intelligent enough to understand that they do have some of those qualities that are required in a management personnel. They have some qualities that that are usually required or expected in an MBA. Okay, you have to really reflect, you have to really introspect and see what those personality traits are that make you that give you that edge as an MBA. Okay, because once you know that, you will never be tricked. Okay, and this is one question that can be asked directly also, but then I would expect all of you to actually introspect and look at those personality traits that could make you a better MBA candidate, and eventually they will these qualities will make you a better employee and one of the best employees in the future. Okay, so guys, think about it. Think about those personality traits. It can be your communication skills. It can be your interpersonal skills. It can be your skills of leadership. It can be your skills of computers. It can be your skills of like impressing people with your marketing. It can be anything. Okay. So guys, these are the five things that you need to keep in mind, and you have to include some of these things or all of these things in the answer that you plan to give. And through these 5 points, you decide the direction in which the interview is going to move. And I hope this is one perspective that you may not have seen, but then with this session, I believe I am able to show you that perspective. Okay, so guys, best of luck for whatever interview you are applying for, and I'm going to see you in the next session. Thank you very much.